Hi everyone, good morning. Today we are going to discuss about the amphibians. Already we learnt about the characteristics features of amphibians. The mostly amphibians are the fast vertebrates which are what living on land and water. The fast vertebrates only. Remaining vertebrates later becomes the fast vertebrate which are living on land and water. That is what amphibians only. And amphibians are the pycholothermic, nothing but we can call especially cold-blooded animals we are observed. Okay, so many characteristics we learnt about what amphibians. And now, we are going to discuss about the classification of what amphibia. Classification, the amphibian, the class amphibia classified or divided into two subclasses. Class amphibia divided into two subclasses. Subclass Stegocephalia, subclass Lysamphibia. Okay, subclass Stegocephalia, subclass Lysamphibia. That means amphibia, the class amphibia divided into two subclasses. The first class is Stegocephalia, the second one is Lysamphibia. Here, the Stegocephalia, whatever Stegocephalia amphibians are, all are extinct, already extinct, disappear, extinct from Earth. Okay, these Stegocephalia look like a lizard, and also what, completely extinct, they look like crocodile and salamander like amphibians, which are Stegocephalia, subclass Stegocephalia. These are all our extinct amphibians, and second character is what, they look like crocodile, just like as it is that much of length, they look like same as it is like crocodile and salamanders, that is also amphibians. Okay, like amphibians, the skull was completely roofed with what, bones. Well developed skull, that means what, the skull whatever is there, it is the completely covered with what, bones. Which one? Stegocephalia. And also teeth are large teeth, enlarged teeth are very large. The skin is what, skin scales and bony plates. Okay, scales also is there, which it is a totally, even roof head is also covered with what, bony, even skin is also covered with what, bony scales. But all Stegocephalia, subclass Stegocephalia, all are extinct. They look like what, like a crocodile like structure, like salamander like structures, but all are extinct. But next one, another subclass is Lysamphibia. Lysamphibia, these are the modern amphibians. Modern amphibians, whatever amphibians now we are seeing, what, totally Lysamphibia, that is subclass Lysamphibia. Lysamphibians are modern amphibians. The lacking bony dermal skeleton. Here having what, dermal skeleton. The skeleton system is, exoskeleton system is made up of bones. It's a bony, covered with what, bony scales. But here, exoskeleton system is, dermal skeleton is what, absent, lacking. Skeleton system is not covering with any scales. And teeth are very small in size. But here in Stegocephalia, teeth are very enlarged. Here teeth are very small and simple. Only upper jaw only having what? Teeth. Okay. These are the one of the characters of what? Lysamphibia. Again, this Lysamphibia classified into three orders. One is Gymnophiona, Epoda, Eurodila, Selenchia or Enura. I'm trying to understand. Okay, what are the names for that? Okay. The subclass Lysamphibia, which is modern amphibians, are again classified, divided into three orders. One is Gymnophiona or Epoda. Second one is Eurodila. And third one is Selenchia or Enura. What are these? These are orders. Lysamphibia classified into three orders. One is Gymnophiona, Epoda, Eurodila, Selenchia. Why the names given what Gymnophiana, Epoda, Urodila and Silentia, Enura? That is also very important to understand the names. Why they come? Because they given these names. The first name given, Gymnophiana. What is the meaning of Gymnophiana? Means what? These whatever amphibians are living in burrows. Okay, making holes or burrows. These worm-like structures, the worm-like epodas are living in burrowing. Holes, burrowing. So that it is called Gymnophiana. And these Gymnophiana, one more kind, blind worms also we can call. Very, very important. Which are called blind epodas. Blind amphibian, blind worm-like structure. Worm means what? The body is what? Long, like worms, earthworm, for example. Okay, like worm-like structure, like a snake, worm-like structures is there. These are limbless, very, very important. Limbless epodas. What is the meaning of epoda? A means absent. Podas means what? Limbs. The legs are, limbs are absent. There is no limbs. So that we can call epoda. Gymnophiana. They are living in burrows. Blind worms. They don't have eye. Eyes are absent. Blind worms. We can call blind. Eyes is there, but it is not useful. Okay, vestigial organs. Okay. So that if you observe the structure of what these are, and also these are also called Sicilians also. We can call Sicilians also. Okay, the important points about what Gymnophiana or Epoda. These Gymnophiana are limbless, what we call amphibians. Okay, they don't have the limbs. Okay, and blind worms. Not visible anything, blind worms. Burrowing, living in what? Burrows. Okay, so that Gymnophiana or Epoda, we can call. And dermal scale, embedded in skin. Dermal, here scales are present. Which scales? Derma scales. The body covered with what? Exoskeleton system covered with what? Derma scales. But males have, okay, producible copulatory organ. Which is a copulatory separate organs is there. Which is, that organ is useful to insert into female body. That is nothing but we can call producible copulatory, which is useful for copulation. The male has copulatory organ, which is useful for reproduction, sexual reproduction. That means male have producible copulatory organ. Okay. These are the characters of Gymnophiana. You have to remember limbless and living in burrowing. And third one is blind worms. These three points are very important, which are Gymnophiana. Just like look like a snakes, okay? And worms. And here, examples of Gymnophiana, Ichthyophis, Uriotyplos, Rhinotrina, Typhlonectes. Okay, here the given example, Ichthyophis. Very, very important example. Ichthyophis, Uriotyplos, and Rhinotrina, and Typhlonectes. Okay, these are the examples of Gymnophiana. Here, Ichthyophis is a very good example. Ichthyophis. Ichthyophis is a limbless amphibian. And showing parental care. Very, very important. Actually, amphibians are not showing parental care. They are not taking care about their eggs. But here, Ichthyophis is very, very important. Ichthyophis is showing what? Parental care. Here, if you observe in this diagram, this is the worm-like body. Here, it is laying the eggs. It is hatching the eggs. It is taking care there about eggs. These whatever black color round structures are eggs. They are showing what parental care. Which one? Ichthyophis. Limbless, worm-like structure, amphibians. Showing parental care. There is no tongue. That is also very important. Whatever characters we learned in about Gymnophiana, everything is important.
Okay, Gymnophiona is the limbless, blind worms, burrowing, living in holes. Okay, the body is covered with scales. And male is protrusible, copulatory organ. And what? Ichthyophis is the limbless amphibian showing parental care. There is no tongue. And these Ichthyophis and Urio, okay, and Uricotyplos, these both are living in India. In some places in India, these are visible. Ichthyophis, whatever, limbless amphibian, and also what? Uriotyplos also visible, found in India. Found in India. And Typlonectas it is visible in South Africa. Typlonectas. Okay, that is also Gymnophiona. You have to remember Gymnophiona or Apoda, limbless amphibians. Look like worm-like structures, long worm-like structure. Here, Ichthyophis, Uriotyplos, both are living in India. And Typlonectas and Typlonectas living in South, found in South Africa, Viviparous. Typlonectas is viviparous. This is also very important. Okay, remaining all are laying eggs. Whatever Ichthyophis, other one, Uriotyplos, everything is Rhinotrima. These are what especially for laying eggs. But only Typlonectas is what? It is the viviparous. Viviparous means what? It is laying eggs. Sorry. It is giving birth to young ones and living in aquatic forms. Aquatic forms mean mostly it is living in aqua, means water, in water only. Okay, only one, that is Typlonectas. Okay, this is information about what Gymnophiona, the order Gymnophiona or Urodila, Apoda. And next class is Urodila. What is the meaning of Urodila? Uro means what? Tail. These organisms having what? Tail. Okay, generally frog do not have the tail. Tail is absent. But here, the tailed amphibians. Urodilas are tailed amphibians. Examples, newts and salamanders. Newts and salamanders are called Urodila. Here, the salamander, just like if you observe this diagram, this is what especially salamandra. This salamander look like lizard. Lizard-like with a distinct tail. Tail is present in these organisms. This is also very important point. Urodila, tail. Tailed amphibians. Example is salamander. Salamander look like a lizard. Okay, and a tailed, okay, distinct tail. Tail is long and distinct. Okay, and tympanum is absent. What is tympanum? Eardrum in inside, okay, which is a vibrating. Eardrum is tympanum is absent in these animals. And also, gills are permanent. Gill, which are useful for respiration. In amphibians, buccopharyngeal respiration, cutaneous respiration, pulmonary respiration, we will observe. Here, it will respirate with what? Gills. These organisms. Gills are permanent. In generally, adult frog, gills are what? Disappear. But here gills are present in their lifetime. Okay, permanent. And last in the adult. Okay, in some are last in adult also. Some other Urodilas. And male without copulatory organ. Try to understand the difference between Gymnophiona. In Gymnophiona, male organisms having protrusible, keeping inside, protrusible copulatory organ. Here, copulatory organ is absent. Male without copulatory organ. Example is salamandra, amblyostoma. Here, Urodila, you have to remember what is Urodila, tailed amphibians. These Urodila, which are called Urodila, newts and salamanders. Lizard-like distinct tail, tympanum is absent and gills are permanent. And some organisms last in adult and male without copulatory organ. Copulatory organ is what which is useful for copulation. Copulatory organ is absent. Example is salamander, look like lizard. Just observe the diagram. and also amblyostoma. And one more example is amblyostoma, which is living in USA and Mexico. Okay, very important point about amblyostoma. The larva of amblyostoma is exolotile. Very important. The larval stage of amblyostoma is exolotile. Exolotile is, what is that one? That is the larva stage of amblyostoma. Okay, amblyostoma, that is found in USA and Mexico. Larva is exolotile. And very important, it shows, these larvas are shows neotenic or pedogenesis. Very important points. Neoteny or pedogenesis, which are showing amblyostomas, larva, that is we can call, especially for what we call exolotiles, were showing neoteny. Very important word, neoteny or pedogenesis. Neoteny, what is the meaning of neoteny? Retention of larval character even after sexual maturity also. Retention of larval characters means for whatever characters is there in larva, they are keeping larva's character even after when it is become sexual maturity. After sexual maturity also, there are showing larval characters. That is we can call neoteny. Neoteny means what? They are keeping retention. What retention? It is retention of larval characters even after sexual maturity also. Even after sexual maturity also, there are showing what? Larval characters. That is we can call neoteny. Very important. What we call that is neoteny. Okay. That is a characteristics of Urodila. Very important. Some more characters are very important for neat exam. And next one, Selenchia. Jumping. Selen means what? Jumping. Okay. Jumping amphibians are ennura. A means absent. Neura means tailless. Tailless amphibians. Try to understand. Here this is Urodila. This is Selenchia. What is the meaning of Selenchia annura? Tailless amphibian. Tails are absent here. What are they? Selenchia examples are, annura examples are frogs, toads. Frog toads are the examples of Selenchia. What is the meaning of Selenchia? Jumping. Jumping amphibians. Jumping. And also what? Ennura. A means absent. What is absent? Neura. Neura means tail. So that we can call tailless amphibians. Urodilas, tailed amphibians. Selenchia, ennura, tailless amphibians. Okay. Frogs and toads are the examples of what? Selenchia. And what are the characteristics of what Selenchia are ennura? Here, tailless, already we learned. Adult without gills. In salamandra, especially for most of the Urodila, even in adult, when it is become after larval stage, adult also what, especially these, what we called, especially for gills are present. Here, in adult frog, gills are absent. When there are in what, especially frog, if we took the frog example, in frog larval stage, we can call tadpole larva. In tadpole larva, it respires with gills. But when it is become adult, it is respire with skin, respire with what? Buccopharyngeal and also what? Lungs. Okay. So that here, adult without gills. And eyelids well formed. Eyelids are well formed. Okay. Eyelashes are absent. Eyelids are present. Okay. And tympanum present. Okay. Try to understand the difference between Urodila this. Tympanum, eardrum, inside eardrum. Eardrum is present in frogs. But here, absent. And the skin is scaleless. This is also very important. without scales, but Gymnophiana body covered with scales. Here Silentia, the body without scales, the scales are absent, always wet moisture, and mandibles toothless, tooth also, teeth also absent. And examples is what? Rana tigrina, Bufo, Rhacoporus. That Rhacoporus, other name we can call flying frog. Flying frog. It is not flying, just it is a jumping one tree to another tree. That is nothing but we can call Rhacoporus. Rana tigrina. That is the scientific name of frog. And Bufo, adult frog. And Bufo, generally, especially for Bufo marinus, that is the scientific name of Bufo, that is also nothing but frog. Okay, the Bufo marinus, it is a poisonous amphibian, very very important, which is poisonous amphibian. Bufo marinus is the poisonous amphibians. Male showing parental care, this is also very important. Even when we are discussing about Gymnophiana and Apoda, in males taking care about what, especially parental care. Here also, male showing parental care. Which one? Bufo marinus, poisonous amphibians. Male is smaller without opal sacs. Just if you discuss about Bufo marinus, that is the one type of frog. This Bufo is a poisonous amphibian. The male one taking parental care. Parental care means what? It is a taking care about the eggs. And also what? Male is small. Compared with female, male is small and without vocal sac. What is the meaning of vocal sac? They are making croaking sound. Croaking sound. Here in Bufo, that which are making croaking sound, vocal sacs are absent. Lack of vocal sacs. Try to remember, very important one. And Bombinator, one more what? Enura. Bombinator is a famous for warning coloration. Coloration means what? It is showing the warning. It is changing their colors when the prey, when the other organism, predator enter into nearby that amphibia, it changing their colors. It's showing what? It's showing, giving warning to change their colors. That is Bombinator. Is famous for warning coloration. Okay. Next one, Rana Goliath. Goliath is the name. Rana Goliath is the largest frog in West Africa. In West Africa, largest frog is what? Rana Goliath. How much length? That is 30 centimeters. Approximately this much of the scale size. 30 centimeters. Rana Goliath is the largest frog which are living in West Africa. How much long? 30 centimeters long. And generally in frogs, male frogs can croak louder compared with female. Male coy at the rainy season, at the time of copulation, the male one is what? Croaking, making sound with vocal cords. Male one is making louder compared with female. Okay, and generally a frog have what? Front limbs having four fingers. Try to observe. Okay. Front and back is there. Front one only having four fingers. And which are what? Backside. Okay. And backside having what? Five toes. One, two, three, four, five toes. One, two, three, four, five. Five toes in backside. Front side only four toes. Okay. Four. Okay. Hands. Especially for four fingers. Front side only having four fingers, in back side having five toes. Okay, try to observe that one. The glands are present, especially the body surface, the frog's body covered with glands, mucus glands. It is releasing always mucus-like substance. Okay, frog is ureotelic. Ureotelic means what? What is the meaning of ureotelic? That is, the excretory material is urea. Even like human beings, even excretory material, frog excretory material is what? Ureotelic. And toads are what? Okay. In toads, toad is also example of what? Selenium. In toads, whatever parotid gland is there, parotid gland is a salivary gland. This salivary glands modified into poisonous gland. Which amphibian? Toads. In toads, whatever parotid gland, salivary gland is there, that gland turns into poisonous glands, like snakes. And horn toads. Okay. Horn toad is nothing but you can call Pyranosoma. Very important. This is also living, a living lizard. It is not amphibian actually. It is a reptile. Horn toad is nothing but you can call Pyranosoma. That is a living lizard. Is a called living lizard. Which are that one? Horn toad. And other example, hyla. Hyla means what? Tree frog. It is living in trees. On trees, it is a okay, and a Rhacophorus, flying frog, it is flying, jumping one tree to another tree. Hyla is what? Tree frog, and Rhacophorus is what? Especially for flying frog, you can call flying frog. Okay, these are information about Selenia or Enura. Try to remember Lissamphibia, which are living. And modern amphibians are Lissamphibia subclass. It is classified into three orders: Gymnophiana, Aripoda, Urodila, or Selenia, or Enura. Okay, amphibia classified into two subclasses. One is Stegocephalia, all are extinct. Second one is Lissamphibia. Lissamphibia divided into three orders: Gymnophiana, Aripoda, Urodila, Selenia, or Enura. Okay, thank you. Okay, I will give some more examples also about what Selenia. Okay, here they are given some more examples of amphibians. Okay, what are the common names of scientific names and common names? Very important for NEET exam, so that we have to learn these also. Okay, here the common names given: Gymnophiana, that means Lissamphibia, subclass Lissamphibia classified are divided into three orders. One is Gymnophiana, some of the examples of Gymnophiana, and second one is what? Urodila, and third one is Enura examples. Okay, common names and scientific names. Here the given the common names. Okay, Ureotyplos. Ureotyplos, that is the scientific name, Gymnophiana, belongs to Gymnophiana. Generally, what we call that one common name is blindworm. Very important. The Uro, what we call that is the Ureotyplos, is the scientific name. The common name is blindworm. Okay, common name is blindworm. And second one, Ichthyophis. Okay, what we call Ichthyophis? Ichthyophis is also belongs to Gymnophiana or Aripoda. Ichthyophis common name is Sicilians. Sicilians. Very important. And Urodila. And second order is what? Urodila. Urodila, one example is Amblystoma. Amblystoma common name is Tiger Salamander. Very important. Okay. Amblystoma, what we call Tiger Salamander. Here Ichthyophis, what we call Sicilians. Amphioma, Congo eel. What we call Amphioma Congo eel. Cryptobranchus, hellbender. Okay, what we call hellbender, common name. Necturus, mud puppy. What we call Necturus? Mud puppy, common name. Proteus, cave salamander. What we call Proteus? Cave salamander. Siren, mud eel. Siren is a scientific name, common name is mud eel, just like eel like structure. Trigon, we can call newts. Trigon, we can call newt. Salamandra, generally we can call salamanders, which are look like lizard-like structures. Okay, these are the examples of Urodila, Amblystoma, टाइगर सालामंडर, एम्फियामा, कांगो ईल, क्रिप्टोब्रैंकस, हेल ब्रेंडर, निक्टूरस, मड पप्पी, प्रोटियस, केव सालामंडर, साइरन, मड ईल, ट्राइगोन, न्यूट्स, सालामंड्रा, सालामंडर, जनरली कॉमनली कॉल्ड सालामंडर. दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ यूरोडिला. देन एन्यूरा, ओके, आर सेलेंशिया एग्जाम्पल्स. इन द फर्स्ट वन इज राना टाइग्रीना, दैट इज अ साइंटिफिक नेम. कॉमन नेम इज इंडियन बुल फ्रॉग, राना टाइग्रीना और इंडियन बुल फ्रॉग. नेक्स्ट वन एलाइटस मिडवाइफ टोड, व्हाट वी कॉल एलाइटस मिडवाइफ टोड. ब्यूफो मेलानोस्टिक्टस, ब्यूफो मेलानोस्टिक्टस, दैट इज नथिंग बट वी कैन कॉल इंडियन टोड. पीपा, पीपा नॉट पापा, पीपा, पीपा, पीपा सुरीनम टोड. हाइला, ऑलरेडी वी लर्न्ड, हाइला इज व्हाट वी कॉल ट्री फ्रॉग. ओके, बॉम्बिनेटर वी कैन कॉल फायर बेल्ट टोड, दैट इज बॉम्बिनेटर नथिंग बट वी कैन कॉल फायर बेल्ट टोड. राकोपोरस, राकोपोरस इज नथिंग बट वी कैन कॉल फ्राइंग फ्रॉग. जीनोपस लेविस, अफ्रीकन क्लॉड टोड्स, हैविंग क्लॉड टोड्स, अफ्रीकन क्लॉड टोड्स. अस्कापस वी कैन कॉल बील टोड. ऑस्टिलोस्टेरनस वी कैन कॉल हेरी फ्रॉग. ओके, नोटोट्रिमा आर गैस्ट्रोथीका, नोटोट्रिमा आर गैस्ट्रोथीका, वी कैन कॉल मार्सुफियल फ्रॉग्स. दीज आर द साइंटिफिक नेम्स एंड कॉमन नेम्स. ओके, ट्राई टू लर्न, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, सो दैट एवरीवन मस्ट टू टेक दीज वट एवर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ कॉमन नेम्स एंड साइंटिफिक नेम्स ऑफ वट जिम्नोफियाना, यूरोडिला एंड एन्यूरा. प्लीज टेक नोट.